Out of the latest on the fight against the coronavirus, billions of dollars are on the way to help fight the outbreak.
Millions of that money will be dispersed in Missouri and Illinois. Today, President Trump signed an $8.3 billion emergency funding bill to help pay for a vaccine and to help the United States catch up to other nations with testing. As of tonight, 14 people have died from the coronavirus in the U.S. According to Johns Hopkins, there are more than 101,000 confirmed infections across the world.
There is a sample of the coronavirus in St. Louis right now. It's in a lab at Washington University. News 4's Russell Kinsall spoke to the lead researcher working to help find a vaccine and stop the disease from spreading even farther.
Samantha, when a vaccine for coronavirus is finally discovered, it might be because of the research taking place right now at Washington University. Researchers at WashU are part of an effort among labs across the country to find the key to stopping the virus right in its tracks.
Researchers at Washington University who are handling a sample of the coronavirus are working in a biosafety level 3 lab. That's the second highest safety level. To stop the virus, scientists need to know it first.
You've really got to understand the details of how these viruses actually function.
Sean Whelan is heading up the research. He's also head of the medical school's molecular microbiology department. Related research is happening in another lab where they're not handling the coronavirus. Researchers are using a virus that infects livestock in their approach to finding a vaccine for coronavirus.
That virus formed the basis of a vaccine vector for Ebola virus that is actually now used in Africa.
Whelan developed a genetic system that other researchers used to develop the vaccine for Ebola. They're hoping the research here will find a way to stop the virus from making people sick. But Whelan says there's no stopping it from spreading to St. Louis.
It's extremely likely that we will see infections everywhere in the country. When that will happen is unknown.
So developing a vaccine is actually a pretty slow process, and even if there's a breakthrough tomorrow, it still has to do a lot of extensive testing on it, so it could be up to a year and a half or more before a vaccine is developed and then finally put into use. Live in the newsroom, Russell Kinsall, News 4.